to the Sunday Business Page.
A young man in a woodworking factory in Kane, Pennsylvania, McKean County, decided that he wanted a different life. His story is the story of a man who says, for success, you must move forward and conquer or be destroyed. Just one of the thoughts William Wooded shares in his book, Always Forward, Discover the 7 Secrets of Sales Success. Bill Wooded joins us now on the Sunday Business Page. Bill, welcome to the show. It's great to have you here.
Thank you, John.
You know, Kane, Pennsylvania, that's way up there in McKean County.
It's hidden away. It's a long way from the beaches of California where I now live, a long way away.
You know, it's hard to imagine going from the hinterlands of Pennsylvania to Laguna Beach.
It's all about imagination. You know, I woke up one day, the Rose Bowl was on, it was sunny in California. I looked outside, it was frigid in Pennsylvania, normal right. conditions until July.
Right.
And I thought, you know what, I have to go to California. I have to find a way or make a way to come to California. And in the 30 years that I've lived in Laguna Beach, California, only two people know where Kane is. And I think they're probably embellishing a little bit.
But you still have your Pennsylvania roots. Look at what you're wearing today.
I've got to say this. I've looked forward to this more than anyone could ever imagine. I watch the Steelers every Sunday, Monday, and Thursday, no matter when they're on. So I am decked in Steeler colors. I'm representing them down to the cufflinks.
Oh.
Blue-collar work ethic in a white-collar world will make a difference for you. That's what punching and moving forward is. I love the Steelers. Had to get that out. Thank you.
Yeah, well, we love Thank that you. You bleed black and gold, even in California. Well, tell us about Always Forward, the 7 Secrets of Sales Success. I love the alliteration there.
Well, thank you.
The 7 Secrets of Sales Success. How many times do we say that?
It took me 2 years to get that one, just the alliteration. Always Forward is a guiding mantra. It's a way. It's a challenge to people, I think, because life is always forward. We can't sit, John, in stasis. We can't sit in a bubble and protect ourselves and think that we have to be safe. We have to move forward. And right. there are steps that I've taken to get out of the backwoods of Pennsylvania, which, again, I love coming back here. It makes me feel alive. But to get out and make things happen, and those 7 secrets are now distilled in this book.
Well, share one or two of them. What do you think are the most important?
Well, my uncle taught me this, and especially today in this day and age of electronics and how we move through, you know, a different information stream. He said, Billy, you can't do good business sitting on your backside. He was the greatest salesperson I ever met. You got to get out. You've got to shake hands. You've got to meet with people. You've got to make it about people and engagement, enrollment, not trying to sell somebody something. You've got to meet people. And so many people today sit in their offices, never step out,
right.
don't meet people.
Well, that's a point that I think you make here. The internet
yes.
is not sufficient for connection.
Impersonal. It has to be personal.
You know, but many of us are still, I mean, we've been told
yeah.
that social media yeah. is the way to connect. You don't believe that?
No, I don't. I think it's us lazy and we're looking for the silver bullet. I will give you this from Western Pennsylvania. There is no secret. It's all in the work. You got to roll up your sleeves and you got to do the work. And what people want today is the 4-hour body. We want a body in 4 hours. We want to do this in 4 hours. We want 4 million in 4 hours. You got to do the work. You got to get down. You got to break your nails. You're going to get dirty. You've got to do the work. I'll give you another one that I think is very important. That's think and do. So the thought and action, the shorter the distance between a thought and a decisive action, the greater your likelihood of success no matter what the endeavor. Think, do, and make it quick because most people won't and don't because they're going to sit behind, push buttons, be lazy, and not want to get out, press flesh, and make things happen.
I do think there's a side of us that does procrastinate.
Absolutely.
I mean, we may think of a good idea, we may want to do something, but we take our time at getting to it.
Well, procrastination is fear winning. It's called resistance. So you're going to sit back here and you're not going to want to move forward. You've got to take those small steps forward. Small steps forward. It's moving through the face of fear. There is no other way. We have to look, face our fears, and take those small steps forward to go always forward.
Right.
It's resistance.
Right.
You know,
fear of winning? Is that what you just said?
No. You've got a fear that you have the risk. You have a certain fear of moving forward. So a fear of winning is almost a fear of success. No. There's a certain fear.
No, I'm saying the suggestion is that a lot of folks have that.
Oh, they do.
And that holds them back.
They do because they get comfortable with what they think they have in the present.
Right. I think that's 100% correct. Is it easy to get this book?
Very easy to get this book. BillWooditch.com. You can find the book. It's on Amazon. And the proceeds go to the Intrepid Fallen Heroes Fund, which I'm very proud to say honors our fallen and the injured and wounded in action and supports their families.
I didn't get that again.
Your Intrepid Volunteers Fund is the charity that the proceeds
Intrepid
of the
Volunteers
go
Fund.
Yes.
That's a great cause.
Thank you. Thank
That's
you very
a great
much.
Cause. So, and that applies whether you do the book or I see you
yes.
have, is, what are these?
Well, I thought you'd get so used to my voice, you'd want more of my voice. So I actually did the voice on that.
So you've actually recorded the book.
That kind of shocked you, didn't it?
Well, you know, it might be easier sometimes to listen mm-hmm. when you're in the car,
yes.
you know, driving around. So the, you know, I have to ask you, Bill, you know, the Pennsylvania roots.
Yes.
How has that impacted your life?
Every day. When I wake up and I look and I think that people, you know, context can bring perspective and perspective can bring appreciation. And you wake up and you think, and I'm proud, where did I come from? Never lose where you come from. That's the anchor for your values. That's what made me, and I think that gives me the edge in business. Never forget that.
Do you think Pennsylvania values help no matter where you go?
Tremendously. The people I've met from Pennsylvania, it's a homecoming every time I meet someone from Pennsylvania. There's a certain way, it's a style. You know, I was telling somebody the other night, when I landed here, it just feels like home. There's something that just feels like home, and I've been in California for 30 years, and it just feels like still a vacation. Right. This is home.
And your mother's still up in Kane, so...
Still up kicking and railing, and she's happy that I didn't swear during this interview.
Well, Bill Wood, it's such a great pleasure to have you on the show. Thank you for all your good advice. Good luck. Keep wearing those colors out in California.
I live it.
I want you to do it.
Thanks,
Good. We'll be back with more of the Sunday Business Page in just a few moments. Stick with us.